Hello, my name is Wade Nomura, and this is Rotary Serving Our Community. Recently, we had a couple here travel to Sri Lanka to do a project, and I wanted to bring them in because, unfortunately, Sri Lanka is one of the areas in the world I have not yet been to. So with me today, I have Helena and Hans Dahlin. Welcome.
Thank you.
I want to start with you, Hans. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
I was born and raised in Sweden. Grew up in a city a couple of hours south of capital Stockholm. I'm an engineer, and fortunately, my work got me here to California when the company decided to have a facility to move to Goleta, and I and my family traveled with them in 2004. So we moved here, and we have stayed ever since.
Nice. Yeah. How about you? Tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm one. Actually, I'm coming from the same hometown as Hans, and we met over there over 30 years ago.
Wow.
So that's a long time. So actually, I was actually a kindergarten teacher. I've been working for that for 30 years. Wow. But now I actually have dropped that work, and I work as a photographer. That's my kind of my dream profession. So that's my new goal to start that, and it feels fine.
Very nice. So how did you get involved with Rotary?
Actually, I was growing up in this world because my dad was a long-time Rotarian.
Oh.
And my mother was actually an Inner Wheel member.
Okay.
So I was starting with as an Inner Wheel member for over 15 years before I was coming to Rotary practically.
Wow.
So I have been growing up since I was a little kid, so I know kind of the things here.
Right.
It feels good.
And how about you, Hans?
I did know a little bit about Rotary because of my father-in-law. But I was never a member in Sweden. But when I was coming over here, it was one time where a Swedish friend came, a Swedish Rotarian friend came to Santa Barbara, and he invited me to go to his meeting there for, what's it called?
Makeup,
yeah. Mm-hmm. So I went with him there on the meeting, and that was in 2008. And then I was a member after that.
Okay, yeah. And the member of which club? You guys got to plug in for your club.
Yeah,
they're going to be watching you, so.
Of course, yeah. Galina
Noontime.
Oh, yeah,
Galina Noontime, good for you.
Yeah.
Great. So tell us a little bit about the project. What project was it in Sri Lanka, and what kind of drew you to that project?
It started in 2012, 5 years ago, and it was Darshan Yong, that was a past district governor from Colombo East Club. We kind of started this project, and he reached out to his former colleagues. In our district, it was Frank Ortiz. So Frank Ortiz had lots of presentations around that time. So we were listening to this at conferences, and we got interested in Sri Lanka. During that time, 2012-13, it was about four different grants was going on at the same time in this district. So it was many clubs that was participating, and Goleta Noontime was one of the clubs participating in that. So after that, it was kind of fading down a little bit from our part. But then in 2014, started up again because we wanted to go to Sri Lanka to find out what this project was about. So we went there, the family went there in 2014. And Darshan Yon contacted us when we were there and said, hey, you're doing a great job. Do you want to continue this and take the lead on this and do another global grant? And we accepted his offer. So after that, we started a global grant in 2015, 16. And then we did another global grant this year, 17, that was just finished.
And what kind of grant was it?
It's actually global grant.
Global grant,
yeah.
Focusing on education.
Education, yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So we're actually going to start this third grand global grant just in a few weeks here now.
Okay.
So it's going
so education, is it for grammar school, preschool?
No, it's for preschool teachers because they passed the law in 2010 that all the preschool teachers must have a diploma.
Oh.
And they didn't have that at that time. So that's why the project got started in 2012 to help those teachers that doesn't afford to have a diploma. So it's a teaching program that's going on for 1 year, and we sponsor them with the money to go to these training centers to do the training for 1 year. So they actually work during the weekdays and do the training on the weekends, Saturday, Sunday, for 1 year.
So the global grant is actually training or teaching teachers, instructors, them ready to
get the diplomas.
Nice, very nice. Okay.
So that's very good.
Great.
So that's how actually grown so much over the years, and now actually this is the biggest and the most important project, Sri Lankan project ever.
Really?
Wow. So that grows and grows, and it's going to be bigger and bigger
the
whole time.
Good for you.
Yeah.
And it's going to benefit nothing but the people. So.
Absolutely.
That's perfect.
That feels good.
You brought some pictures. Let's take a look at your pictures. First picture we have is a picture of you hiding behind a camera here.
Yeah,
so tell us a little bit about that picture.
Actually, we were preparing, just before we left, we were preparing all stuff with all the boxes and everything with backpacks and everything. And Hans was kind of concerned, have you all the camera stuff with you now and everything that we're going to go for the camera lenses. And we kind of have a photographer and kind of documentary all things together. And that we usually do during our trips too. Promote everything afterwards.
Now the boxes, if I recall, you grabbed some of our t-shirts.
I know, we did.
So that's in boxes.
I know.
With the solar lights.
I know. That was really good, actually. Nice. It was a really good handout. So this project is not just to educate and help the teachers. We even had a special hands-on project on the side to help the preschools with material too. But that's a kind of the special thing for us to do on the side. So it feels good, and the people, especially the kids are, and the teacher are so happy and so relaxed with that. So that's what we're going to continue with.
So how did you get all that over there?
That's another thing. Yeah, but we had one backpack each.
Okay.
And one box each.
Okay.
That's the rule.
Yeah. Okay.
So it was regular check-in.
Yeah.
Okay. Gotcha. Yeah. Okay.
But it's important to say that the global grant, as Helena said, it's about funding money for the teachers' training. And this thing with moving boxes full with educational material is more like a hands-on side project.
Okay.
That's not part of the global grant.
Okay, got it.
But we like to, as most Rotarians like, is to have hands-on work. So
that's
why we
That's good for you.
To the preschools. Yeah.
We are actually collecting a lot of preschool material from actually the area over here and brought it in boxes and take them over there.
Okay.
So this is the second time you're doing that.
Good, good. Next picture we have is a picture of you. I couldn't figure that one out. With boxes still, it's just you guys getting ready and packing up.
Yeah, that's what,
that's kind of the finished product of what you're going to try.
Oh, yeah, this is what I'm going to have.
Okay, I got you.
Santa Barbara Airbus.
Okay, oh, good, good. And then you have a map here showing us the locations that you went to.
Yeah. So this is, the dots here are training centers that are located in Sri Lanka.
Okay.
And the red dots are supported by District 5240.
Oh, wow.
So most of the dots you can see is the red ones from our district.
Very nice. Good job.
So we are the leading district.
I can see that. And then the next picture we have is of the school itself.
Yeah, this is the first preschool visit we did in Jaffna, and we were staying there for almost 2 hours and handed out the preschool materials and was looking for if we can do some more things in the future, what kind of environment they were looking for. And it was a great experience to see. I was surprised that there was even better standard than I actually expect. So it feels interesting to see all this. And our youngest daughter, Sarah, was actually kind of showing all the kids here the material that we brought.
Okay, so that's your daughter there?
Yes, the youngest one. She's a teacher too. So.
Oh, she is, okay.
Yeah.
So she went with you?
Yeah.
The three of you went?
Yeah.
I see, okay, great.
In 2014, we went all four.
Wow.
Both daughters.
Oh, that's great. Next picture you have shows probably one of the teachers then?
Yeah,
one of the teachers.
Teaching. Okay.
So our request from the part over there was that we would like to meet the teachers that were going to go to the diploma ceremony the day after.
Okay.
So we met up with the teachers at two different preschools where they're going to. So this is one of the teachers that had the diploma and got next day, the Saturday.
Great. And you have another picture here of part of the school then?
Yeah, they're actually during a lesson.
Okay.
So the teachers was holding and we were watching everything and were actually being very involved and active in the whole process.
Nice.
Oh yeah, nice. That's good.
And then picture with you there.
Oh yeah,
doing something here.
We were actually handing out wooden toys in the boxes, from the boxes, and the kids were so eager to see what we were doing with it, and were eager to be involved in the process too. So of course they were all over the place in the classroom.
So where did the toys come from?
They were actually from another Rotary club here in the area, actually Conejo Valley. Some have supported, and there are a lot of other interact clubs.
I've seen those now that you mentioned it.
I know, they're good, they're really good actually.
They are, very nice. Then the next picture is you doing a banner exchange there.
Yeah, we do.
So one of the teachers, the left teacher on the left side, was the one that was going to get the diploma.
Okay.
The other one got through this program 1 year ago, so she had gone through this program also.
Great, great. And the banners, they leave at the school or?
They are staying in the school.
Very nice.
Just to have it kind of remember us.
Very good. And then the next picture you have is another school, or is that the same school?
It's actually the same school, before we are leaving. And kind of the kids was actually very funny with this, because we had kind of a cheering club, and they were so happy to see us, and it was hard to leave them.
Yeah, I'm sure it would be. I know. Of course, you're going to go back. So
They were asking, are you coming back tomorrow, please?
Tomorrow.
Are you coming back and play with
us
tomorrow?
Very cute.
So, it was great.
Good.
And the kids over here, they were fun, and they, we were playing a lot with them, so.
Now, you have a video clip, right, of this?
Yeah, we have.
So why don't we go ahead and take a look at that and see? And
if
you can, you could talk over and explain to us what you're seeing in the video, because
of course, yes.
It sounds like a, well, I get the trip out of it this way.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
You can see what it's like. So Jaffna, that's the location then of the school?
Yeah, it's going to Jaffna. It's the northern part of Sri Lanka.
Oh, okay.
And the war, civil war ended in 2009, so it's still burned out houses there.
Yeah, see that.
So this is kind of the poorest area in the whole country, so that's why we are focusing on this.
Is this the school that was in the pictures there?
Yeah, this is from the from the school we visited.
Like welcoming ceremony.
Nice.
And they are talking Tamil, so it's kind of hard to understand. We had them translated with us too, and one Rotarian was helping us there with the language too. Mm-hmm. So.
Beautiful school though.
I know, very quality was very high, and it was very fun to see, and I was so surprised and very happy with the quality, more than I ever expected.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was better than the East Coast where we were 2014.
Yeah, and they were very eager to show and tell us everything they have gone through so far, and we had a lot of help.
The man in yellow shirt there, he's president of the Jaffna Club, Rotary Club.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And the man in blue shirt is an educator, and he's a part of a teaching team for the training centers.
Okay.
And they're singing and watching everything.
See what they can do.
Oh, this is part of the picture that you showed us, part of the lesson plan.
Yeah, and here the kind of lesson plan I had
too. Good. A lot of discipline.
Oh yeah, the whole time. Everything you see over there is so different than what you're used to.
Colorful too, everything is
I know, the artwork is fantastic. And all this material we brought actually from here. So
including this puzzle.
Yeah, we did.
It
come mostly from the Hollister School in Galita.
Okay. The house, did they donate that then?
Yeah, they did.
Our youngest daughter is working there.
They cleaned out,
they cleaned out things from the summer. And then
very nice.
Okay.
Very
nice.
Yeah, she's supporting them here too and showing them how to work with the material.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody was very eager to be involved in this too, so.
Yeah. I can't believe how orderly these children are.
Yeah, that's manner.
Good manner. I know. We were so surprised, actually.
I'm very surprised.
Oh, I know. So we couldn't have stayed there the whole day if you had the time.
This is true.
Yeah, absolutely. It was so amazing feeling.
Now, these children, are they also coming from a lower income demographic?
Yeah, they are.
Okay. Well dressed, they're all in uniform.
Yeah, they are supported in the community with these uniforms. So,
I'm kind of surprised that the structure is so nice. I mean, they got floors, they got
they have everything
painted walls, and they got a roof and ceiling that's not leaking. That's good.
I know.
That is good.
So they are coming back very good after the war, civil war. They have been so good and coming back here.
And age of these children are how old?
They are between 3 and 5 years old.
3 and 5 years.
Yeah. So it's kind of the goodbye.
Oh, okay. Very cute.
Yeah, so it was hard to say goodbye to them. They were eager to see us the next day.
Yeah. Right. Well, very good. Well, thank you for sharing that one.
Yeah.
Now, how many of these schools did you actually get to visit on this trip?
This trip was just 2 schools.
Just 2 schools.
This, yeah, because the travel schedule was so tight.
Okay.
So.
Well, you told us, let's see, 24 hours by plane to get there, yeah. Plus another 7 hours by car.
Yeah. So
oh my gosh.
That was tough. Just from one thing to another thing.
Yeah.
The whole time.
And how long were you there?
We have told you the time we were there for 3 weeks.
3 weeks?
Yeah.
Okay.
But when we were there in 2014, we were at 3 different preschools on the East Coast.
Good. Very good. Now, you have one other video brought for us, too. Did you want to show that one? That's kind of the ceremonies, correct? Graduating part.
Yeah.
So let's go ahead and jump into that one and see what you have there, because I think that's unique, and that's kind of part of what the project was all about.
Yeah, this is kind of the real highlights
in
the whole trip.
Very good. So the gentleman in the center would be?
He's a governor in the North District in Sri Lanka for the parliament.
Okay, okay. And the rest of them are probably staff people?
Actually,
I see the press, you got good press coverage there.
You see the back of Darshan Yonder.
Oh, is that Darshan there?
Yeah.
And one member is actually from the school ministry.
Okay.
So if a few people that are from the government, the Sri Lankan government.
Wow.
Yeah.
So there was a lot of celebrities, and we had no clue when we started the ceremony how big it's going to be.
Yeah, Darshan didn't leave anything for us. He said, just be there and you're going to have fun.
Surprise you, huh? Yeah, there was a
big
surprise.
That would be Darshan. Yeah, I met with Darshan when he came here to our district.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So this was a very special feeling to be in this ceremony and starting up. We had no clue in the beginning, but it's actually over 300 students who are going to take the graduation.
Mm-hmm.
So we are part of that, and then we really showed out. So actually, we are going to be actually one big part of all the ceremony.
Wow. And these are all the graduates?
Yes.
That's impressive.
Yeah, it is. And the beautiful dresses and everything.
Now, how much of that actually was the global grant?
This is supported by the grant we did in 2015-16.
Mm-hmm. And is it 100% of those? Is it 50% of those graduates?
100%.
100%.
Oh, my gosh. Very good. That's a serious impact there.
Oh, yeah.
Very nice.
So they're actually showing us the kind of the tradition what they are, how everything works.
Mm-hmm. I see. Very, very traditional.
It was very powerful. It was a very nice experience.
Mm-hmm. So this is actually inside then?
Yeah,
after
this is
the
inside.
Processional, then you're inside with the presentation. Then.
Yeah. And here's the governor for the northern part of Sri Lanka. Mm-hmm. That's a very big power in the whole country, actually, too. So.
Okay.
He's a former teacher, too.
Oh, he is?
Yeah.
So he's very involved with this one. I'm sure he appreciates the project.
Absolutely, absolutely. Really big supporter.
Okay. And so this is an early presentation prior to...
When they come up to stage and get the diplomas.
Okay, got it.
So it was a lot of speakers. Before.
I'm sure that's the case.
But we were on stage actually the whole time.
Oh my goodness.
Oh yeah.
So who's doing the camera work for you?
Our younger daughter.
Our daughter.
Yeah.
Very nice. And this is actually the graduating.
So this is this is the teacher that we visited the day before.
Oh, yeah, okay.
That's why I have this picture.
Nice.
So we actually was giving out the diplomas and the medals.
Great.
And that was very powerful. It was a very special feeling to have been going through this.
I'm sure that's the case.
Oh, yeah.
Because the teachers now became real.
Yeah.
Before they had been just the figure on the paper.
True.
But now we had them in front of us. So
true. Really and how many did you actually graduate through in this grant?
About 300 for this grant.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, yeah. And there's much more to come in the future. Yeah. Far from done.
Yeah. Very nice. Now, the teachers, are they already assigned to specific schools, or are they going to be moving around to different areas? Do you know?
No, they are mostly assigned to where they work now.
Okay.
They're not likely moving around.
Okay, okay.
Because of their, they don't have enough money to travel so much.
Mm-hmm.
So
this is you, so you get to do the presentation also?
Yeah, actually I have a short speech.
Okay.
And I'm starting actually in Sinhalese.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow, good for you.
Yeah, I did it. I take the challenge too.
Good. That's very good. I'm sure they appreciated it.
Oh, yeah. It was actually kind of fun because everybody in the audience had no clue when I started up what to do. But it was a great thing to do that.
So hard was the language to learn.
It's kind of tricky, but yeah. I have a few people around me who kind of help me. So.
Oh, that's good.
Very especially good. The letters are hard to read.
I bet that is. So you have to write phonetically, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah, I tried everything. I tried everything.
So tell us, on this trip, how much of a life-changing experience was that for you to do this project? Something that you imagined, anticipated, something unique?
This was kind of a unique trip. I think it was the most interesting trip for us, I think, because it was so many people we met during this. So we got to learn and to meet with all the culture really up close, because we lived in Darshan's family also with him. Mm-hmm. So it was very come close to the families.
True. Now, had you ever imagined that you were going to end up in Sri Lanka doing a project like this when you started Rotary?
No.
No.
But we have always liked international travels, and we have been backpacking with our children since they were very small.
Oh, okay.
We started when they were 6 and 8 years old.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So we were backpacking in Asia many
years. 6 and 8 years old, that is a
lot. That's a long time ago.
Yeah, and that's pretty young to start them.
Oh,
good
yeah.
for you.
So, this is a logical path mm-hmm. on this travel experience
yeah.
that we have.
And we have done kind of different this kind of projects before in the past, so it's kind of natural for us just to continue things in this way, and we're going to absolutely continue to do it in the future.
So tell me, how much was the grant? Was the global grant the first one? The one that we just saw?
The first one in 15-16 we did was 47,000, and this one that we finished this summer was 50,700.
Nice. So about $100,000 total to put out that many teachers.
Yeah.
Wow. And the cost for one teacher is about $100, $100 to $120 per teacher.
Not too bad per teacher.
But the really fun things with this is actually the total grant and the numbers of the teachers for the whole project for the 5 years is actually 3,500 teachers that we have supported.
Okay.
And over 70,000 kids have been supported. And now the total grant sum had been actually 43,500.
435.
Yeah.
Wow.
So that's the total amount so far, and that's going to grow.
Okay. So the program, as you do it, for sustaining it, is it now the government's going to be able to maintain this? Have you trained teachers to actually be able to do this, or just curious?
Some of the teachers will have they can support themselves to buy this education,
mm-hmm.
but not all of them. So this project must go on.
Okay.
Continue.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So the government has not yet adopted the model then that you guys have presented.
No. Partly they will do it, but they're not there yet.
Okay.
They have concentrated on class 1 to higher level.
Oh, I see.
And they have forgotten about the preschools.
The preschool, yeah. Gets them ready for school.
Yeah.
So that's why this project was started by Darshan, because they have didn't need this.
Makes sense.
Also. Yeah.
It makes a lot of sense. Mm-hmm. Now, preschools, with that many teachers that you've graduated out, is that in percentage? Do you have any idea what that would do for the country? Is that like 20%, 10%, 50%? Just curious.
It's hard to tell, actually.
Say.
Yeah, it's hard to say.
Yeah. Okay.
But what we learned that actually, that this had been a great impact and very big impact, not only for the teachers, the families, the communities, and for the whole country. So it seems to be very important to continue
for sure.
at least for more to 3 to 5 years probably. Then we're going to see what's going to happen after that.
Okay.
Maybe going to continue for at least more 4 or 5 more years before we open.
But it sounded like your focus was actually in the lower income areas. Say the North region was one of the areas that was in most need.
Yeah.
So that is a good one.
Yeah. And the East Coast.
Yeah. Oh, and the East Coast.
Yeah. So next grant is going to be more focusing on the East and the South Coast.
Okay.
Next time.
Okay.
But if you look at the picture there, the map. Mm-hmm. With all the dots, you can see that it's located all through the whole country.
I did notice that. And you've covered most of the coastline also, mm-hmm. so that's very good. Have you worked with and have you met most of the other national figures as far as education? Talked to them? Seems to me that would be a big opportunity for you. And something quite unique that you could do.
We haven't met yet.
We need to talk to Darshan about that.
Oh yeah,
I'm sure he could line that up.
Oh, absolutely. I know he's kind of a great man. Yes, to focus on that too.
So. Yeah, very good. So, tell me about this. Now that you've done that, have either of you experienced what we call the Rotary moment, knowing that you did the right thing for the right reasons?
Yeah, we did. I think we have many moments.
Yeah,
there were actually two girls who was coming and approached us right after the inauguration ceremony, and actually tapped us on the shoulder and said, "Excuse me, can we talk to you?" And they were thanking us for that we have supported them with their education and the future. Wow. Because there had been some great impact. Yeah, it's actually over this picture.
Okay,
over
we can go into the last picture.
Yeah,
okay.
the last picture.
That's a beautiful picture.
Yeah, they told us they have been helped so much. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, they have actually ended up on the streets. Mm. That's why we feel it so much for this, and we're going to continue to help and support everybody that need the help. So
life
this
changing,
is kind of the real Rotary moment for us.
They had been going through this teaching last year. So the year before.
Good, good. And you plan on keeping in touch with them? Do you stay in contact now with them?
Absolutely. Nice. Absolutely. We're going to continue too. So.
Well, for the two of you, you know, it's an amazing project. And appreciate all you've done. I'm sure you've changed a lot of lives. As you say, those numbers are huge. And again, my hat's off to you for doing international projects. That's something unique that Rotary does, and not everybody gets to experience that. Mm. With that, everybody, thank you very much. Take a look at some of the projects being done around the world, because it started here in Goleta Noontime Club, and it's going around the world changing lives. With that, thank you very much, and we will see you next time.